I'm accomplishing that goal up here. See, here comes the auditor, the assessor now. She's been called on before. Request for modifications to the agenda, which I know we have three.
We do.
Yesterday.
Yeah, we have three. We'd like to add as item 2E an agreement with Dale Camerer for outside counsel under a special deputy prosecutor appointment to continue work on matters of pending litigation. Item 2F, amendment number 1 with Lauren Erickson extending her hearing examiner services until May 31st. And item 3B, authorizing the application for 2016 Washington Federal Lands and Access Program grant for the Joyce Piedmont Road reconstruction project.
Move to approve the modified agenda.
Second. And second, so I have one question for Mark. So the agenda talks about an agreement with Dale Camerer for pending litigation. Based on yesterday's conversation, it was more of the board's wanting to come in and take a look at alleged hostile work environment that we're creating. So I don't think that's pending litigation. Is there other pending litigation he's working on as well?
No, I had a chance to review the news media coverage of this, and I wanted to make a few things clear for the benefit first of the board and then the traveling public as well. Number one, there is no claim for damage that's been filed with the county, nor is there any litigation. As the board is well aware, there have been some verbal statements made by the county treasurer that sound in relation to hostile workplace environment, retaliation, and those are the terms that she has chosen to use. In the normal course of county
written correspondence directly to the board.
Yes, and in the normal course of county business, when that sort of language is used, it triggers a reporting obligation to the Washington County Risk Pool. That previously occurred. Mr. Camerer was brought on board to perform what's called a pre-defense consult to look more closely at what was happening within county government to ensure that there was no impropriety or corrective action that was needed. This is designed, the special deputy appointment, to facilitate his continued work in that regard. It's important to note that Mr. Camerer is not being brought on board as an attorney for the Board of Commissioners. This is an arrangement that would have him provide service under the auspices of the special deputy appointment. He will be looking at the organizational interests, that is, the county as his client, with essentially a check and balance through me as to billings in particular. The manner, mode, form, and content of the advice that he provides to the organization has yet to be determined. That's something that he'll develop after he reviews the record. Whether or not an investigation is conducted is a decision that has yet to be made. But at this point in time, out of respect for the organization, which needs to be in the business of the continued provision of service to the community, I believe that bringing him in will, number one, resolve a potential conflict issue that could develop as to the prosecutor's office. It will allow us to continue the provision of advice as to day-to-day matters to the treasurer. It will also allow a vehicle through which the organization can come into possession of some advice that hopefully will allow everybody to focus on their respective jobs with a clear delineation as to where one elected official's job ends, another's begins, so that the legislative body can focus on its work, the treasurer can focus on her work, other involved collectives, the auditor, for example, can focus on her work with confidence and assurance that the process is playing out in the way envisioned by the state. But this is not a circumstance of an attorney being brought in so that the board can lawyer up vis-a-vis the interests of the treasurer.
That wasn't the board's intent yesterday, by
no stretch. No, that's not what's happening, and I'll be providing the direction to the attorney to that end. So he will be providing advice to Clallam County as an organization to make sure that we're continuing the provision of service to the public. My mission will be to make sure that he does that in the least expensive way, and again, we also view it as necessary to have him involved to cure a potential conflict of interest that could develop in the future, just depending upon how things turn out.
So Will he look specifically at the allegations of hostile work environment?
He's aware of those.
Will he be looking at that?
He will be looking at that, yes. But it's neither the board nor the treasurer is going to be directing this attorney as to what he does. I'll be talking with him again with the mind's eye towards what the organization needs to get back to business in a very efficient way. More to come.
So should we change the agenda language that talks about how bringing him in for matters of pending litigation?
I was just going to suggest we just stop after special deputy prosecutor appointment, period.
That's probably better, don't you think?
Sure. I mean, it's no secret that the treasurer has threatened litigation verbally. So I don't think that's a secret to anyone. I don't think there's any reason to talk around that. But when that sort of language is used, it triggers certain things happening, be it at the state level, the county level, or the city level. Most notably, they report to their respective insurers the existence of a possible dispute that could expose the entity and by implication the public fisc to some liability. That's an outcome that I certainly view as unacceptable. And so, again, Mr. Kammerer, I believe, will be able to come to the table with some value-added legal advice that will benefit everyone.
My concern is that there's written documentation specifically to the Board of Commissioners, basically in sense saying we are allowing a hostile work environment, harassment, threats, and retaliation against another elected official, and I don't see anything but somebody neutral that doesn't work for the board needs to take a look at those allegations. Those are serious allegations made against the three of us, and we're sitting here, and I do not want the public to think that we're I do not want to stop any investigation, come in and take a look at how we do things, and if we're doing things wrong, then we will change. I'm confident the three of us will change how we do business. So, but that's written, that's not just verbal. Those are written documents only to the Board of Commissioners. So that was my point yesterday.
Right.
When I said that the board needs to have someone come in and look at this. And if we're doing it again, if we're doing anything wrong to create a hostile worker, as I understand the law, those are serious. Those are not minor allegations. Those are very serious allegations against the three of us up here.
Yes, which is why they were reported to the county's insurer. Rest assured, if there's a need for advice, if that's a concern, that advice will be forthcoming. But
we need someone to let us know what if anything we're doing wrong to create such a hostile work environment. Because that's what I'm being told by one elected official, that this is a hostile work environment, harassment, threats, and retaliation. To the point where she can't even meet with the board, with one commissioner and the auditor in a statutorily authorized committee.
Sure. And I would just urge, the board has control over its own actions. I would urge it to focus on its legislative duties and the discharge of those in the same way that I would recommend all electeds to focus on their duties. Frankly, this has been a distraction in the past, and it's taken energy away from the county in the provision of service to the community. And I think what would behoove all of us and benefit the citizenry is if we stay focused on the prize, which is providing the service that everybody is expecting us to provide. So.
While I appreciate that, in the past, we have investigated other elected officials, and I do not want the public to see that somehow the Board of Commissioners is above being investigated. In the past, when accusations were leveled against other elected officials, full investigations occurred, and I'm actually calling for a full investigation to eliminate the public assuming that the three of us are stonewalling. I welcome it. I want to know what we're doing wrong. I'll apologize if I'm doing something. I mean, there's nothing, but we've got to be investigated because this is the same situation in which other elected officials have been investigated in the past. So that's what I'm asking. I don't know who to ask to do that, but that's what I believe should happen. We should be fully investigated as if we've investigated other elected officials for hostile work environment, retaliation, threats, and harassment.
And your position is duly noted. I don't think anybody's going to take a position that you're stonewalling that. That's a potential option available. Frankly, sometimes it's helpful to have people who are uninvolved take a look at what's going on from outside because they can bring a level of objectivity, which is beneficial to all. And I think it instills further confidence with the public as well. So The trick is to do that in a way that does not result in an escalating price tag. And you know, we're involved early on in the county prosecutor's office. We haven't always been in past circumstances, and so we need there to be some benefit in being able to help steer things in a direction that results in a functional outcome, one where hopefully the organization just stays focused on discharging its duties, again, continued provision of service, and in a way that allows for all electeds to do their jobs and work together in a productive way. So, more to come, and I'll certainly relay your request and your desire.
Since we don't have so there's a motion to modify the agenda and the modification on item 2E stops after special deputy prosecutor appointment. All in favor?
Aye.
Motion carries. Public comment for agenda items. Is there any member of the public wishing to make comment on agenda items? And for those who are here, there are worth three added items that you may not be aware of. So before I ask for comment, the first added item was the agreement with Mr. Cameron for outside counsel. The other amendment one with Lauren Erickson for extending her hearing examiner services. And the third addition to today's agenda is authorizing application for the 2016 Washington Federal Lands Access Program grant for the Joyce Piedmont Road reconstruction project. So is there anybody wishing to make comment on any agenda items? Yeah, Ken.
Item 3B talks about yesterday the authorizing application for the Washington Federal Lands grant for the Joyce Piedmont Road reconstruction. I'm glad to see that project's a very challenging road, and if the 101 project that the state's going to do is going to funnel a lot of traffic over there, that's going to be very helpful. I'll be a little sad to see the curves go away on a nice summer day. It's fun to drive that road, but beyond that reconstruction, I guess I'm concerned about the Y Road intersection. And beyond that, if they're going to go west on 112, Y Road itself is extremely narrow. And when you get west of the Y River, that road changes quite a lot too. So Ed Bowen stopped driving recently because of the slide issues out at east of Deep Creek. So I think the state should be very concerned about the condition of 112 before they funnel a whole bunch of traffic over there.
Thanks, Ken. Is there anybody else wishing to make comment on agenda items? Yes, sir.
Name's Ed Johnson, or Ed, three blocks ago. I would like to publicly speak out against funding the EDC. Thank you, Commissioner Chapman, for discussing this with me in the hall of fame, for taking the time. In 1956, the county had about 26,000 people. In 2014, it had about 72,000. When does a county say too much is enough? I say it's now. I'm against county funding of the EDC.
Mr. Johnson, sir, thank you. Any questions? Anybody else wishing to make comment on agenda items only? We have one piece of email correspondence that we should read into the record. It's the commissioners. It's from Judy Larson, 1070 Palo Verde Loop Swim. She writes, I made a quick scan of the packet for today's meeting and did not find details about item 2D, agreement with the Clallam County EDC. I have concerns about using so much of the taxpayers' funding for economic ventures which have not clearly provided economic benefits to many county constituents. Thank you for your consideration.
I looked online, it's there.
Yeah, I had through
hundreds of pages. You may have just skipped over.
Maybe the clerk could at least respond to her on that, explain where she could take her word, she could have found that document. Anybody else? Okay.
Thank you. Item 1A is approval of vouchers for the week of February 15th. And item 1B is approval of minutes for the week of February 15th.
Move to approve the consent agenda.
Second.
Moving seconded, all in favor?
Aye.
Motion carries. Reports and presentations, Commissioner Rosias.
Last week I attended the Peninsula Regional Transportation Planning meeting. We had a pretty substantial overview of the new federal transportation bill, which is going to have some significant and hopefully positive impacts around the state, certainly here in the peninsula. It's the first time in a number of years that there's been stable funding for transportation projects. So, and at least in terms of planning, I'd say that was a step in the right direction. And also just an update, many may know that there's been conversations going on for years now about an off-river reservoir off the Dungeness River. Just to provide the public and my fellow commissioners with a little update about that, we're looking at potential funding sources, but before that, working to determine if a project like this is going to happen, who's the proper landowner, and that's sort of the first step. So that's what that working group is starting to delve into right now. And that's all I've got.
Yesterday at the Clallam Transit Board meeting, I was asked and accepted an assignment, actually on the same board that Commissioner Rosias has, the regional, it's the rural transportation planning committee. And I bring it to everyone's attention because now we'll end up in a scenario where we have two commissioners attending the same meeting. Trish, if we can make sure that we get the word out to the public, it's a quarterly meeting.
Is it the same meeting, or is it the one that Rich James goes to that the board doesn't?
Well, it's got to be the same, because transit has a seat on that board.
Yeah, and I think that you accepted the position of second, so if the primary person from Clallam Transit can't go, then you would go in their place.
But just in case, right. When I end up at the same meeting,
right.
I wanted to make sure that the public was aware. The second thing is that last Friday I attended the Trustland Advisory Committee meeting, and the request from that committee to the county commissioners was that they postpone delivering the report that they're to do next month, because they are still working through some fundamental issues. And my suggestion is that we schedule it for a conversation at a work session. I did indicate that I bring it to the board's attention, and that I do not believe the board's intent was for them to do a very large, comprehensive report, and that something they might consider doing is just a real quick bullet, come to a commissioner's meeting, brief us on those bullet items so that we are aware. But at any rate, in the interest of everybody else being able to sit in on that work session in the next couple of weeks, if we could do that.
Right, yeah, just work with Jim on the schedule. Or Trish. Jim?
Nothing for me.
Contracts and agreements.
Item 2A is an agreement with Superior Court regarding the handling of judicial administrative records, as was discussed in work session on February 16th. This is a memorandum of understanding. There's no budgetary impact.
Move to approve the agreement with Superior Court regarding the handling of judicial administrative records.
Second. Spoken seconded. Any questions, comments? All in favor?
Aye.
Motion carries.
Item 2B is an agreement with District Courts 1 and 2 regarding handling of their judicial administrative records. Again, as discussed in work session February 16th.
Move to approve the agreement with District Courts 1 and 2.
Second. Spoken seconded. Any questions, comments? All in favor?
Aye.
Motion carries.
Item 2C is amendment number 1 with BergerABAM Inc, increasing the contract amount for additional work on the McDonald Creek Bridge project. This increases the maximum by $115,947 to a maximum of $339,237, all as was discussed in work session on February 16th.
I move to approve the amendment with BergerABAM Inc.
Second. Moved and seconded. Any questions, comments? All in favor?
Aye.
Item 2D is personal services agreement between Clallam County Economic Development Council and Clallam County in the amount of, a one-year agreement in the amount of $150,000, as was discussed in several work sessions.
Move to approve the agreement with the Clallam County Economic Development Council.
Second, it's moved and seconded. Comments, questions?
I just have one additional comment to the public and to the fellow who is here. He's not still here. I understand that there has been a lot of concern from the public over the course of years as to the efficacy of the EDC, and I would like to assure the public, at least to the extent possible, that the contract and the agreement we've come up with this year is an attempt to acknowledge that and an attempt to for all of us to understand the benefit that we as a county are or are not getting from the EDC. And this contract will require regular reporting, both written and verbal. And I feel good about the metrics and the reporting requirements that we are asking of the EDC. It's a substantial change from previous practice. If anyone has any further questions about it, then I'd certainly be happy to talk to them in greater detail after the meeting.
And I'd like to say thank you very much, Mark, for the work that you put into seeing that we have some very specific measurable outcomes, and we're going to see reporting against those.
That's right.
And I think the EDC, especially the fact that you've been very successful recruiting from the private industry, thank you for your success, and we wish you well in continuing this effort to benefit all of us in the county.
So it's moved and seconded. We accept the agreement with the EDC. All in favor?
Aye.
Motion carries. Thank you very much.
Item 2E is agreement with Dale Cameron for outside counsel under a special deputy prosecutor appointment, as was discussed yesterday in work session.
I move to approve the agreement with Dale Cameron for outside counsel.
Second. Moved and seconded. Any further questions, comments?
I would like to reinforce your comment earlier. My interest is in understanding whether or not we're doing something wrong. My interest is not in trying to defend ourselves. I think that it's important for the organization to, for all of us to understand what's happening and what isn't happening. So, just a reinforcement of your words.
And I'd just like to share that the commissioners have made a concerted effort, under largely the leadership of Commissioner Chapman, to collaborate this year. And I think you may have seen some of that collaboration. You can count on that professionalism to continue. And this isn't a distraction. We will continue to do the job you hired us to do.
Appreciate those comments, gentlemen. All in favor of the agreement?
Aye.
Aye.
Motion carries.
Item 2F is amendment number 1 with Lauren Erickson, extending her hearing examiner services until May 31st, 2016.
Move to approve amendment with Lauren Erickson, extending her hearing examiner services.
Second. It's moved and seconded. Any questions, comments? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Motion carries. Thank you very much to Lauren for continuing. While we go down the other pathway. Administration.
Item 3A is a notice of hearing to be held March 15th at 10:30 a.m. regarding proposed amendments to Clallam County Code 23.03, General Parks and Fairground Rules and Regulations, all as was discussed in work session on February 16th.
Is there a motion to call for the public hearing?
I'd like to make a motion, sorry about that, to call for the public hearing March 15th at 10:30.
I'll second the motion.
Moving seconded. Any further questions, comments? Nobody from Parks is here. We have a work session and we'll have the public hearings. All in favor? favor?
Aye.
Motion carries.
Item 3B is authorizing application for the 2016 Washington Federal Lands Access Program grant for the Joyce Piedmont Road reconstruction project, as was discussed yesterday in work session.
I move to authorize application for the 2016 Washington Federal Lands Access Program grant.
Second, the comment?
Second. Go ahead, Bill, thanks.
We had a member of the public present the fact that there are other projects in the county that are also in need of, road projects that are in need of attention, and so in conversation with the commissioners and with Ross Tyler, one of the things we're going to be able to do as part of the budgeting process this year is to look at the unfunded projects on the transportation improvement plan, and I got the sense that would occur between July and, say, October. And that's in response to the question presented by a member of the public. But it also does a good job in as much as it is time for us to take a look at some of the projects that have been there and have had no action to answer the question, should they still be there.
Thanks for taking the lead on that. And I support the work that we need to take a look at that in the second half of the year. I think a lot of the projects are in your district anyway.
So. Yeah, figures.
All in favor of the grant application?
Aye.
Motion carries, and if that motion was, I assume the intent was for the chair to sign the grant application as well.
Yes, please.
Budget. Oh, wait. Oh, is that it for administration?
Yes.
Yep. Budget.
Item 4A is resolution adopting the following budget revision under juvenile services. It is a revision of $397 coming from subscriptions and going into information technology software to correct that the original quote did not include sales tax for the purchase of said software. So it's not an increase in the budget, it's just revising from one category to another.
Move to approve the budget revision.
I second.
Okay, seconded. Any questions, Pete's here? Yeah. Any questions, Pete? All in favor?
Aye.
Motion carries.
Item 4B is resolution adopting the following supplemental appropriations. Under Public Works Equipment Rental and Revolving, receipt of funding from the Sheriff's Office to replace a patrol car that was wrecked in March 2015 in the amount of $7,500. And receipt of Sheriff's Office funding to replace the evidence van in the amount of $10,000. Under Juvenile Services, reimbursement from Washington State Patrol in the amount of $4,919. And under auditor, unbudgeted funding for the February 2016 election in the amount of $47,000, and unbudgeted funding for the May 2016 election in the amount of $100,000. Those are the supplemental appropriations.
Move to approve the supplemental appropriations.
Now, second.
Approved and seconded. Any questions, comments? Do you guys have anything? So Shoot is here, and this is kind of off the point. So let me vote on this, and I'll bring up another issue. So all in favor?
Aye.
Motion carries. So while Shoot is here, last week we finished the canvassing board for the school bond, and then there's a schedule coming up. There's a May election, there's the primary election, and there's a general election. And there was talk that with upcoming elections and a change of the board, that really, I think I may need to deputize the two of you for these next set of elections so you guys get some experience. The canvassing boards are pretty complicated. I know you went to the handwriting analysis class. I think Shun has got one in your future, so well, she'll get you. So I think I just wanted to put you guys on notice that for the good of the organization, for a smooth transition, so there's people that have some experience under Shun's leadership, and Mark, he's experienced, and I've probably done more canvassing boards than any commissioner in the last 15 years, so. It's important in transition, so don't be surprised. We'll talk about it, but the next one's in May, then you'll have August, and you have the general to begin. And so I'd like to give both of you guys some experience before the end of the year. Probably one of you will be the chair next year anyway, and that will be your duty. So it's interesting, it's fascinating. We're dead serious down there, and we take our duties very seriously, but it's It's an interesting dynamic and gives you an insight and an inside look into elections that you'll never get anyway else. So I just wanted to put that on the record. Seemed like this was a good time. So Shuna, as the next one comes forward, loop me in, but then I'll take it. Maybe you can come to the Board of Commissioners work session and we can figure out which ones you do, which election, which one of these guys, depending on your schedule. So. Okay, is that okay with you guys?
Good idea, thank you.
I hope Bill is better at his signature matching class than I was.
Oh no, it's a tough one.
It was
fun. I have a secret that I finally let everybody in on last week. Buy me a cup of coffee during the end of the year, I'll let you know my secret too. It's very scientific. Right, Mark? Anyway, budget is completed and open to awards, no community development, no public works. Public hearing at 10:30. Gosh, we're running out of time, I believe. 10:31. So we have a public hearing. That's a consideration of a resolution adopting the following budget emergencies.
Yes, thank you. And this is pursuant to RCW 36.40.140 that we had after today's public hearing. The following constitute public emergencies which could not reasonably have been foreseen at the time of budget preparation. So the process is to list these hearings, answer any questions that the board might have, open it to the public, and then after closing, if the board should adopt to all of the budget emergencies, the monies would not transfer for 5 days until an opportunity for anyone in the public to issue a challenge in Superior Court. So with that being in mind, consideration of resolution adopting the following budget emergencies under public works, equipment rental and revolving, a portion of funding to replace the sheriff's office patrol car wrecked in March 2015 in the amount of $24,500. Portion of funding to replace the sheriff's office evidence van in the amount of $14,000. Under auditor, adopted budget assumes 260 work days. The actual for the year is 262. They need an additional $3,600. Under health and human services, environmental health, to repair outdated water lab equipment in the amount of $8,000. Under sheriff's office, purchase vehicle to be used exclusively for the expansion and improvement of controlled substances related enforcement activity in the amount of $15,000. And under sheriff's office animal control to pay veterinarian feeding and boarding costs for livestock animals seized in a 2015 animal cruelty case in the amount of $5,000. Those are the budget emergencies that have been applied for and properly noticed, and I will answer any questions the board might have about any or all of them.
Any questions from the board before we open the public hearing? Hearing none, we'll open the public hearing. Nobody has signed up to testify. Is there anyone here wishing to make comment on these budget emergencies? Seeing no one, close the board. Close the public hearing.
Move to close the public hearing.
Second.
It's moved and seconded to close the public hearing. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Motion carries. Motion to adopt the resolution.
Move to adopt the resolution.
Second.
Moved and seconded. Any questions, comments? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Motion carries. So that completes the public hearing. Public comment? Is there any member of the public wishing to make general comment before the board? And let us sound easy today, huh, Francisco?
Yep.
No executive session. The calendar, I think we have a pool meeting this afternoon.
And I apologize, I've already called.
Right. Well,
I'm going to step away
from that. Wasn't on our calendar. At least one commissioner will be at the school district meeting. The two of you will be tomorrow in Forks. I wish you all the best.
Thank you very much for doing that
one. It's my pleasure. Thanks for
being here. If not, we'll continue this week's meeting the next Monday at 9 a.m. No objection. No objection so ordered.